Welcome back to Engineering Graphics class. In this session, we are going to discuss the isometric projection, how to solve the problem using isometric sheet. Okay, let me discuss the problem number 22. The question is given like this. A fresnel of a cone, base diameter 50 mm and top diameter 25 mm and height 50 mm is placed centrally on a cylindrical slab of diameter 100 mm and thickness 30 mm. Draw the isometric projection of the combination. So here we have a two object. The first one is cylindrical slab that should be done at the bottom, and the top of that we need to place the frustum of a cone. The first cylindrical slab we'll construct, that is 100 mm diameter they given. So we need to take the 10 boxes count from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. And then again 10 boxes here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then again this side also we need to count 10 boxes, and then you can join back to you. So after making this, we need to draw the lines to opposite edge midpoints. We need to draw the lines, two lines from the bottom corner, and same way from top corner to bottom edges, two lines we need to draw, and then we will get the four center to draw the arc. Then we need to draw the arc with the thick line. First take the bottom corner as a center and draw the arc to the top between two midpoints, and then take top center as a point as a center and draw the arc between bottom two points, and then intersection point you take it as a center and draw the right side, draw the left side arc. Next, after finishing this, we need to give the thickness. So before going to that, we need to delete the inside line, because if you make the more number of lines, it will lead to confusion. The thickness of the cylindrical slab they given 30 mm. So we need to draw the from all the corners three boxes. We will move it down from here. 1, 2, 3. And same way from here. 1, 2, 3. Then from here. 1, 2, 3. Then from the top corner, 1, 2 and 3, and then join the bottom of these lines, corners, we need to join it, and then you can delete these vertical lines. Now as same technique, we need to go to the bottom corner and draw the line to the midpoint of the opposite edges like this here, from here to this one, and from top corner to this is the bottom edge, and same way this side also we need to draw it. And next we need to draw the arc with the thick line, then take the center and draw the arc between the midpoints, and take the bottom corner center and draw the arc between midpoints, and then intersection point take center and draw the arc, and then another intersection point take its center and draw the arc. Like this we need to draw the arcs to get the bottom face of the cylinder. Once we got bottom face, we can delete all the reference lines, because it is not needed. Only the top frame you keep it to get the center. And then we need to draw the tangent line. Keep the scale to the periphery and draw the tangent line to the top and to the bottom circle. Like this we need to draw the tangent lines. After drawing the tangent lines, we need to erase the circle, the bottom circle coming inside of this, we need to erase. So after trimming, so we need to get the top shape, we need to construct it. Before going to that, we need to get the midpoints, draw the lines to the midpoint of opposite midpoint edges, so we'll get the center. So after getting center, now the top object, so we got it. Here we need to draw the frustum of a cone. The base diameter 50 they given. So first we'll construct the base diameter 50. To construct the 50 means we need to divide it off. 25 we need to take it. That means here we can take the boxes from here 1 and 2 and 0.5. So like this. Here from here same way. 1 and 2, 0.5. Then same. 1, 0.5, 1 and 2. It will come here. Then again. 1 and 2, 0.5, same way, 0.5, 1, and 2, then 1 and 2, 0.5, same 0.5, 1 and 2, 1 and 2, 0.5, then join it back. Like total, if you count it, it should come 25. Here 1, 2, or here from here 1 and 2, 3, 4, 5. So total, this is the side 25, we are getting it. And after that, so we need to follow the same technique. We need to draw the arc from bottom, that means a line from bottom corner to opposite edge midpoints, and same way top corner to the opposite edges, the bottom one midpoints, we need to draw the lines. And next we need to draw the arc by taking the visible, means we need to draw the arc with a visible line from top corner here by taking the bottom corner, and draw the arc between the top midpoint edges, and take the top corner center and draw the arc between bottom two edges, and then intersection point, draw the left side arc as well as right side arc. Like this we need to get the bottom face of the frustum of a cone, and after that we need to delete everything, and you can keep the center because we need to give the height of this cone, frustum of a cone. So the remaining all these edges you delete it, keep the center. And now the height of the cone, we can measure it. They given the height of the cone is 50. So from the center, we need to give the height 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So this is the point we are getting the top face. The top face diameter they given 25. So when they give top face diameter 25, means we need to measure 12.5, we need to take it. Off of that means around one box and slightly more than that. So here we can take it one box and slightly more than that, and same way this side also one box and slightly more than that, and here one box and slightly more than that, and from here one box and slightly more than that, like this. And then again here you can extend the same thing, one box and slightly more than that, you can join it. Here one box and slightly more than that, and then here one box and slightly more than that. Like this we can get the top frame. And next, as usual, same from the bottom corner, draw the line to top edge midpoints like this, and same way top corner to bottom edge midpoints, we need to draw the lines, and we'll get the centers. And we need to draw the arc with the thick line, visible line, take the bottom point as the center, and we will draw the arc between the top midpoints, and then take the top corner center and draw the arc between bottom two centers, and then intersection point we'll draw the one arc, and then another side intersection point we'll take another arc. Like this we need to draw the arcs and get the top face of the frustum of a cone. And then you can delete all the lines whichever we taken for reference, everything you can delete it, and including frame and center line, all the things we can delete it because those things we not needed here now. And last we need to draw the tangent lines from the top face to bottom one, this is the frustum of a cone. So keep the scale to the periphery, and we can draw the tangent from top cone to bottom, that is our cone surfaces here like this, from here to the bottom. Like this we need to draw the two tangents. After drawing the tangents, the whatever the portion coming inside of this cone, frustum of a cone, we need to erase it. So like this we need to erase it, and this is how complete the problem.